Today I would like to discuss dinitrogen complexes. Dear students, I am Dr. Digna Varghese. Dinitrogen complexes. Molecular nitrogen, that is N2, is isoelectronic with both carbon monoxide and the nitrosyl ion. Isoelectronic means the same number of electrons. Nitrogen has 14 electrons and the carbon monoxide has also 14. And with NO plus is also 14. But despite the numerous complexes of carbon monoxide and NO plus, for many years it proved to be impossible to form complexes of dinitrogen. We know in carbon monoxide there is carbon and oxygen, and in nitrosyl ion also nitrogen and oxygen. These are made up of heteroatoms. But in the case of nitrogen, that is formed by the same nitrogen atoms. So in carbon monoxide and nitrogen oxide, nitrosonium ion or nitrosyl ion, in that particular compounds there is some electronegativity difference, so it is polar. But in the case of nitrogen, same electronegativity, so it is a non-polar molecule and is normally inert in nature. This difference in behavior was usually ascribed to the lack of polarity of nitrogen, and it resulted in inability to behave as a pi acceptor. The first dinitrogen complex, characterized in 1965, resulted from the reduction of commercial ruthenium trichloride, that containing some ruthenium 4 also, by hydrazine hydride. Here representing the reaction, that is ruthenium trichloride treated with the hydrazine hydride and forming the first dinitrogen complex, that is RuNH35N2+. The pentamine dinitrogen ruthenium 2 cation that formed could be isolated in a variety of salts, that is RuNH35N2+ cation that formed could be isolated in a variety of salts. Some other methods were found to synthesize the complex, such as the decomposition of pentamine acido complex, that is RuNH35N3+, and even direct reaction with nitrogen gas. We can synthesize RuNH35N2+ ion formed by the reaction, that is ruthenium trichloride reacts with the hydrazine hydrides and forming this cationic complex. But this compound can also be formed by the variety of salts, but some other methods are used to synthesize the same complex by the decomposition of the pentamine acido complex and also even the direct reaction with the nitrogen gas. Here RuNH35Cl2+, that is in the presence of zinc mercury in water, it will give RuNH35H2O2+. RuNH35H2O2+ that undergo direct reaction with the nitrogen gas, that will replaces the water molecule RuNH35N2+. That is the same molecule as we have seen the synthesis from the ruthenium chloride and also from the nitrosine hydrazine hydride. The unexpectedly strong nucleophilicity of dinitrogen, shown by its displacement of water, is also exhibited in the formation of a bridged complex. The nitrogens here, the nucleophilicity, strong nucleophilicity of dinitrogen is shown from this reaction, that is dinitrogen can replace the or displace the water molecule and forming the pentamine dinitrogen ruthenium 2 ion complex. In that, the formation of a bridged complex, that is RuNH35N2+ RuNH35H2O2+ will give RuNH35. This dinitrogen can replace the water molecule here and forming a bridged complex like this, RuNH3 5 N2 RuNH3 5 4 plus plus water. There are two structural possibilities for terminal dinitrogen ligands and two possibility for bridged cases also. There is entente terminal, that is metal nitrogen nitrogen, that is on terminal like, that is known as entente terminal. And another way of attaching the bridging is like that, entente bridging, that is M metal nitrogen nitrogen metal. And here the side on terminal, that is metal nitrogen nitrogen metal. And side on bridging is like that, nitrogen nitrogen, that is coordinate to the also to the metal atom. So there are two structural possibilities for the terminal nitrogens and two structural possibilities for the bridging nitrogen. Since then, many structures of other dinitrogen complexes have been determined, including the bis dinitrogen crown thioether complex shown in the figure. That is here a thioether complex that contains the dinitrogen, and structure, this is the complex of or the structure of molybdenum complex, that is MO Me8-16-ANE, that is the thioether ligand, and two nitrogen atoms are attached to this. Me8-16-ANE is the structure of this one, that is actually the thioether complex or thioether ligand that is attached to the metal molybdenum. An X-ray study of the original ruthenium dinitrogen complex indicated that the nature of the ruthenium nitrogen nitrogen linkage was entone. Accurate determination of bond lengths. From the original X-ray structure of the ruthenium dinitrogen complex, that is RuNH3 5 N2 2+, indicated that the nature of the RuNN linkage was entone, that is entone terminal. Accurate determination of by measuring the accurate determination of the bond lengths, that is from the X-ray diffraction method, single crystal X-ray diffraction methods, we can directly get the bond lengths of the compound. The result for this complex are atypical and show that nitrogen greatly resembles carbonyl ligands in its bonding to metals, that we can see from the XRD. Back donation of electron density from the metal into pi antibonding orbitals, that is actually happens in the case of metal carbonyl ligands, in that metal is in the electron rich state and the carbonyl ligands firstly donated to the electrons to the metal, and in order to attain stability of the metal, it back donate electrons to the pi star antibonding orbitals of carbonyl ligands. In the same way as that of the back donation of electron density from the metal into pi antibonding orbital is apparent for the short metal nitrogen bond. Here it is molybdenum nitrogen bond, which is more similar in the length to an molybdenum carbonyl bond than the normal molybdenum ammonia bond in amine complexes. The mean nitrogen nitrogen bond length, that is 110.7 picometer, is slightly greater than that found in molecular nitrogen, that is about 109.8 picometer. Suggested a weakening of the nitrogen nitrogen triple bond in from the donation of electron density into the pi antibonding orbitals of nitrogen, that is the value of 111.6 picometer for bond order of 2.5 in N2 plus. Actually, the metal is donated back to the electrons to the nitrogen atom or nitrogen molecule that is accepting the electrons in the pi antibonding orbitals of the nitrogen molecule. So there is a weakening of the triple bond in the from the molecular nitrogen. That is actually length is actual length for molecular nitrogen is about 109.8 picometer, but in the case of metal nitrogen bond, and it is about the bond length nitrogen bond is that is N-ton terminal bond length is slightly longer than that of the molecular nitrogen, that is about 110.7 picometer. This suggests that a weakening of the nitrogen triple bond from the donation of the electron density into the pi antibonding orbitals of nitrogen from the metal. There is no examples of side on bonding by nitrogen or binding by nitrogen have been confirmed in non-bridging complexes. There is two types of terminal bonding of nitrogen, molecular nitrogen to the metal atom. One is N-ton terminal and the other one is side on terminal, but there is no examples for the side on terminal nitrogen atoms. The Raman stretching frequency of free nitrogen is about 2331 cm². Upon coordination, this vibration becomes infrared active and shifts to a lower frequency. For example, strong nitrogen stretching bands occur at 2105 cm² for the first reported complex, that is RuNH35N2+, and at 1955 cm² and 1890 cm² for the trans molybdenum N2 twice Me8 16NeS4. So Raman stretching frequency is about for the free nitrogen, that is the molecular nitrogen, is the value is 2331 cm, but upon coordination this vibration becomes infrared active and shifts to a lower frequency value, that is shown here the value as 2105 cm² from the complex for the complex RuNH35N2Cl2, and its value for Raman frequency value for complex molybdenum complex is about 1955 and 1890. In that complex molecular nitrogen is attached to the metal atom. They are in the trans position. Here we can see the diagrammatic sketches of the molecular orbitals of the carbon monoxide. One is pi bonding orbital and the other one is pi antibonding orbital. Carbon monoxide is not only a better sigma donor but also a better pi acceptor. So that is in the top position of the spectrochemical series. This is to be expected on the basis whatever the polarity exists in the carbon monoxide molecule. That is, we can see the polarity difference in this total electron density contours picture. For the carbon monoxide is first given here, and on the right of your that is for dinitrogen molecule, there is no polarity difference, but in the case of carbon is on the left side and oxygen is on the right side, there is some polarity difference that indicates the total electron density contours. And here we can see the bond molecular orbital diagram for the carbon monoxide molecule, and here the carbon atoms orbitals are arranged, and for oxygen it is on the right side. But we can see the electrons are filling on the molecular orbitals are more oxygen-like than the carbon, because oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. And here the 1 sigma, 2 sigma, 3 sigma molecular orbitals are essentially 1 sigma, 2 sigma and 3 sigma and 1 pi molecular orbitals are here. In that 1 sigma and 3 sigma molecular orbitals are essentially non-bonding. The bond order of the bond order is here as in the case of nitrogen, that is 3. The superior pi accepting ability of carbon monoxide also accounts for the instability of carbonyl dinitrogen complexes. That means the superior here, comparing to the nitrogen and carbon monoxide, the superior pi accepting ability for carbonyl ligands than for the dinitrogen molecules, that also accounts for the instability of carbonyl dinitrogen complexes. In the case of CrCO5N2, this is a complex containing both carbonyl ligand and dinitrogen ligand. And in the case of cis CrCO4N2 twice, that is also contain the same carbonyl and nitrogen as the ligands, that will be stable only at low temperatures, because when it is warmed, or it is the temperature at which it is stable, from that we increasing the temperature of the complex, that will decompose. So replacing the carbonyl ligands, if we replacing the carbonyl ligands with nitrogen, some other ligands such as phosphines, can provide sufficient electron density to significantly enhance stability. Hence other complex, that is in the same group of chromium, that is molybdenum, MoCO3 PCy3 twice N2, that is here CrCO5N2, that carbonyl ligand is replaced by some phosphine types ligands, that is here substituted phosphine ligand is replacing two carbonyl ligands from the complex, and MoCO3 PCy3 twice N2 can be isolated at room temperature. But in the case of carbonyl nitrogen complexes, stable only at low temperature. If we warming the complex, it will decompose. But this carbonyl ligand substituted by other ligands such as phosphines, that can provide sufficient electron density to the complex, that will enhance its stability. So it can be isolated at the room temperature. Now we are discussing the bridging nitrogen complexes. We know there are two types of bridging nitrogen complexes, that is enton bridging and a terminal enton terminal bridging and a enton sorry sidon terminal sidon bridging. In the case of ruthenium complex, that is RuNH3 5N2 plus 2 plus and RuNH3 5 H2O 2 plus, nitrogen is strong nucleophilic, that will displace the water molecule and forming a bridging dinitrogen complex is formed here. And this bridging is like that: metal here it is ruthenium, nitrogen, then ruthenium, that is metal enton bridging. When dinitrogen functions as a bridging ligand, it usually exhibits the end-on coordination. End-on coordination. Example for the end-on coordination is shown here by the ruthenium pentamine dinitrogen complex with the ruthenium pentamine aqua complex and forming an end-on bridging metal complex. There is another example that shows bridging side-on complexes, and recently reported the example of first dinitrogen complex from the complex of F block element, that is samarium is here and 2 nitrogen is coordinated here as a bridging side on ligand, that is metal nitrogen metal and here this is nitrogen bond. This is known as the bridging side on complexes, and the first one is ruthenium as end-on coordination. Okay, there are 2 types of bridging dinitrogen complexes. The coordination of bridging dinitrogen complexes in that is end-on bridging and also the side on complexes. Here we can see the structure of the complex for the F block elements, samarium, eta 5, C5, Me 5, twice. Samarium complex obtained from the reaction of samarium C5, Me 5 twice and dinitrogen. The 2 samarium atoms and the 2 nitrogen atoms were in a planar arrangement. The samarium nitrogen bond distances suggest the presence of samarium 3, implying a reduced nitrogen-nitrogen bond. But strangely enough, the nitrogen-nitrogen bond distance is 108.8 picometer, that is even shorter than that found in the molecular dinitrogen. That we know the value is 109.8 picometer, that is 1 picometer is lesser here in the case of side-on bridging dinitrogen. The ability to synthesize complexes containing dinitrogen, especially those with considerable alteration of the electronic state of nitrogen, opens up possibilities of direct fixation of nitrogen from the atmosphere, a long-standing challenge to the chemist. It also provides an insight into the closely related process of biological fixation of nitrogen and the enzyme systems involved. So, nitrogen fixation is another example for the dinitrogen complexes that is involved in the nitrogen fixation reaction. Nitrogen fixation is a process by which the molecular nitrogen in the air is converted into ammonia or related nitrogenous compounds in the soil. That is, here the molecular nitrogen, that is atmospheric nitrogen, converted into ammonia or related nitrogenous compounds in soil. That is the nitrogen fixation. Atmospheric nitrogen is molecular dinitrogen, a relatively non-reactive molecule that is metabolically useless to all but a few microorganisms that converts atmospheric nitrogen to the compounds into the soil. Biological nitrogen fixation converts nitrogen into ammonia, which is metabolized by most microorganisms or by most organisms. Biological nitrogen fixation was discovered by German agronomist Hermann Hellriegel and Dutch microbiologist Martinus Beijerinck Biological nitrogen fixation, that is BNF, occurs when atmospheric nitrogen is converted to ammonia by a nitrogenase enzyme. The overall reaction for biological nitrogen fixation is dinitrogen, that is converted to ammonia. Here the hydrolysis of 16 ATP molecules, that is equivalent to 1 molecule of hydrogen. The conversion of nitrogen to ammonia occurs at a metal cluster, the iron molybdenum cofactor. The mechanism proceeds via a series of protonation and reduction steps wherein the iron molybdenum cofactor cluster that act as the active sites hydrogenates the nitrogen substrate. In free living diazotrophs, nitrogenase generated ammonia is assimilated into glutamate through the glutamine synthetase or glutamate synthase pathway. The microbial NIF genes, that are the genes produced to encoding the enzymes for the nitrogen fixation required for the nitrogen fixation, are widely distributed in diverse environments. In vivo nitrogen fixation, there are several bacteria and blue-green algae that can fix the molecular nitrogen in vivo. Both free-living species and symbiotic species are involved. Anaerobic Clostridium pastrinium, aerobes like Klebsiella pneumoniae, and strict aerobes like Acetobacter pinnalbridi. The most important nitrogen-fixing species are the mutualistic species of rhizobium, that is living in the root nodules of various species of legumes, that is clover, beans, peas, etc. Here we can see the biological nitrogen cycle, and what is really the nitrogen fixation is that molecular nitrogen is fixing to ammonia or some other nitrogen containing compounds to the soil by microorganisms which contain nitrogenase enzymes. The nitrogen converted to ammonium salts or ammonia by nitrogenase enzyme, and this ammonium can be converted to several proteins, nucleic acids by other mechanism, and this ammonium salts can be converted to hydroxylamine, and this hydroxylamine converted to nitrites by using enzyme hydroxylamine oxidoreductase. Ammonium salts can be directly converted to nitrite by nitrite reductase enzymes. Nitrites can be converted to nitrates by nitrate reductase enzyme, and nitrites can be converted to nitric oxide by nitrite reductase enzyme. This nitric oxide can be formed from the amino acid arginine by using enzyme nitric oxide synthase. Nitric oxide can be converted to nitrous oxide by nitric oxide reductase enzyme. This nitrous oxide can be converted to nitrogen by nitrous oxide reductase. So it is a biological nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen is fixing as ammonia or some nitrites or nitrates to the soil by nitrogenase enzyme. This again converted to nitrogen by several steps. This reaction occurs at normal temperature and pressure, but we know when nitrogen combined with the hydrogen to form ammonia in Haber process, that is occur at high temperature and high pressure conditions. But this is a wonderful reaction that occurs at normal temperature and pressure by the use of a simple enzyme nitrogenase. The enzyme in nitrogen fixation is nitrogenase. Two proteins are involved here. We know enzyme is a protein, but all proteins are not enzymes. Here in the particular nitrogenase enzyme, two proteins are involved. One is the smaller one, has a molecular weight of 57,000 to 73,000, and it contains iron 4 sulfur 4 cluster. The larger protein is an alpha 2 beta 2 tetramer, alpha 2 beta 2 tetramer, with a molecular weight of 220,000 to 240,000, containing 2 molybdenum atoms, about 30 iron atoms and about 30 labile sulfide ions. The iron sulfur cluster probably act as redox centers. It is possible to isolate a soluble protein-free cofactor containing molybdenum and iron in that 1 molybdenum, 7 to 8 iron and 4 to 6 sulfide ions. Recombination of the cofactor with inactive nitrogenase that will restore the activity. Here we can see the iron sulfur cluster and iron molybdenum cofactor, and also the diagram of the nitrogenase proteins, and in that a schematic representation of the iron protein component and the molybdenum protein iron protein component with metal cofactors. Structures of the iron sulfur cluster, that is F, that is P cluster P, and iron molybdenum cofactor M. Here we can see the catalytic cycle of nitrogen fixation. It seems like the active site for the catalytic binding of dinitrogen involves the molybdenum atom, and the coordination sphere consists of several sulfur atoms at a distance of 235 picometer. The cycle begins with the nitrogen coordinated to the molybdenum and forming a dinitrogen complex here, that is molybdenum coordinated to the nitrogen in an end-on terminal fashion. The oxidation state of molybdenum remains unchanged until the last step of the when it is oxidized from molybdenum 3 to molybdenum 4. For the rest of the cycle, dinitrogen is bound to molybdenum via a double or triple bond accompanied by the change in oxidation state of molybdenum from plus 4 to plus 5 and release of 2 equivalents of ammonia gas here. Here molybdenum coordinated to form molybdenum dinitrogen complex in an end-on fashion, and by the electron transfer reaction the molybdenum nitrogen bonded to a double bonded or triple bonded form, and 2 equivalents of ammonia gases releasing here by the simple fixation of nitrogen. Thank you for your attention.